officially I'm done with the university. So today I got a very happy email saying that I passed my master degree studies and I'm finally done with my education. If I want to go for a PhD, then I'm done with my education. So I finished consumer psychology master's degree at Anglia Ruskin University in Cambridge. And today I will tell you briefly what I think about the university, how was my experience at university, and would I even recommend this university. I know many of you are asking me questions like, what do I think about business school at university? What do I think about theatre at Anglia Ruskin? What do I think about IT? I think recently someone asked me about IT and business studies and finance. I think that was finance as well. I have no clue. Every single department at the university, at any university, is different. Every university have different departments. So I cannot really answer this question just based on my experience, because my experience is based on the psychology department, some teaching styles, but within psychology and science. If I will tell you my experiences from this university, I will be talking from my experience. I know that different departments have different teaching styles, different buildings, different equipment, different tutors and lecturers, so it can be completely different world in different departments. So today I'll briefly talk about my experiences and what I think about this university. We'll be focusing on four different aspects that for me they're the most important. I picked this university because of these four things, and today I will try to explain how they met my requirements or didn't. So number one, teaching. What university has to offer? University is there for a reason, to give you education, to teach you something, and for you to come out from university ready for the world. For me, Anglia Ruskin University was good when it comes to teaching and all right with the quality of teaching. They did great job trying to move from physical lectures in during the week. Basically, they had 7 days to prepare for remote working whilst the virus was happening. So the virus happened when I was in sixth or seventh month of my education. And for the first few months, I was at the campus. I had lectures with people there, but then everything moved to online remote working and I could move to my parents' house to live. So this teaching style can be different, because right now every one of you will experience more of online learning. But for me, teaching was okay. I kind of felt like we didn't get much of practice, if that makes sense. We had amazing people coming in on our lecture. So my supervisor was organizing these guest lectures where alumni, so people who studied at this university and graduated and created a business or did something amazing, came in and were talking about their experiences. And these lectures were actually the best out of everything that I've went through at this university. They were amazing. I found only one drawback, and this was the amount of work we had to go through. So I signed up for 12 months full-time degree, and I had only 1 day per week at uni, and the rest of the days I could work or I could do any other projects I was working on, but only 1 day was for education. And I kind of thought that it's not enough. I'm not a nerdy person, I don't want to be at uni all the time, but at least 2 days a week would be better, just because I couldn't communicate with people in my class because we didn't have enough classes together, any practice together. We didn't pair up and talk to each other. And the sad thing is that I left university and today I've graduated after 12 months and I know only one person properly, just because we didn't have enough lectures together, because we didn't have many days in together and we didn't communicate. And during the times of virus, we didn't communicate at all. I had a few lectures when the university went remotely. We didn't have many lectures together, and the university really didn't think of networking with other people, about talking with other people outside the lectures, outside the course. So it was hard, and people did not seem to be willing to meet new people, to meet new friends. we went on lectures, we listened to lectures and we left home, and that was not great. I'm sorry to mention different university, I'm really sorry. I know this video is about Anglia Ruskin, but I have to mention it. During my undergrad, when I did in Bedfordshire University, we had plenty of opportunities to meet together, to work as a group, as a team. But the difference was, I was 4 days at university during the week. That was full time as well. So I felt like there was not enough of communication between students and not enough of activities that we could do together as class. So this is like my experience that I'm talking about. Okay, number two, accommodations. The university actually did a good job because they bought many, many houses around university in very short cycling distance. So they were privately built houses. Now they're used for students. I was renting one with 5 other people, so I was the 6th one. So it was 6 of us in the house. They were lovely people, incredible flatmates. I finally found really good flatmates to live with for a few months, because then I had to move out because of the crisis that happened. And yeah, so they were really cheap in comparison to the prices that you would pay normally in Cambridge. You can pay from £450 per month up to £900 per month for a room or a studio. Studio is more than £600. Cambridge is very expensive to live in. It was really good. I would recommend everyone who is coming from different country or international or EU student to live in student accommodation. Because first of all, you meet new people. Secondly, you don't have to think about rent and bills and paying for water, electricity, Wi-Fi, rubbish, anything. You're just paying one price and that's it. You're done. So student accommodations were really good. And yeah, I was very happy about this experience at least. Number three, the equipment the university have and the amenities, the activities they have, how good they are prepared to have students and work with them practically. For me, practice is very important. That's how I learn. I cannot learn from just reading and writing. I have to do something to remember. So when I thought about doing my dissertation, I thought, what I want to do during my dissertation, if even the university has the equipment to help me with. So I was looking at EEG equipment, any other brain activity equipment, eye tracking technology. So I was looking at basically everything that university has to offer, and I was happy with the equipment they provided. However, I was not able to use any of these equipments just because we had to leave and move everything remotely, and I had to do my online questionnaire. And number four, the environment in general. In what city the university was or town, how many shops were around, how many gyms or swimming pools, how many people were living there. So for me, it was very important to live in town where I could develop myself. And previously I lived in different place where the development was not the best. There was not many things I could do after uni or after work. So this time I wanted to move somewhere else, and I moved to Cambridge. And Cambridge is incredible. It's an amazing, beautiful town with river, with different pubs, restaurants, coffee shops, the mall. You name it, honestly, there is everything there. The climate, the atmosphere is unique. It's not only Anglia Ruskin University, but also the famous University of Cambridge. And so just the atmosphere is incredible. I really enjoyed living in Cambridge, and I felt like living in Cambridge was the best experience during university. I'm glad I finished and I've graduated, and I'm happy I got the paper. But I kind of felt like living in different place, living in a different town that's giving you development and is giving you these uni vibes. It's just amazing. I still love this place. I still love it. I did a very short video about going through Cambridge in 2 minutes, so you can take a look at that. So in conclusion, teaching university in general was okay. Would I recommend it? Yes, why not? It's not the best uni on the planet, you have to be aware of that, but it's very multicultural, very diverse, very non-judgmental. It's great food in a canteen. So yeah, why not? I would give it 4 out of 5 stars, actually. Yeah, I don't want to be that harsh. It was good. I would recommend it. So that'll be it. If you have any questions, you can always comment me down below and I'm gonna try to answer your question. But please be specific. I'm getting many questions about university and living in Cambridge, but they're very generic and I cannot answer them. I just don't have time for answering and asking questions of what do you mean by that or what exactly, what. Just give me specific questions, please. So then I will definitely 100% answer these questions. Thank you guys for listening. And I'll see you guys next video. Bye. It's not only questions in comments below.